kept them out of the game. Joe Barry Carroll, with this reverse stuff, led Purdue with 25 points. Paxton returned to the game to lead the Flyers in scoring. He wound up with 18 points in a losing cause as Purdue clobbered Dayton 84-76. This is Bud Petropoulos reporting.
Only one Big Ten team has ever won the NIT. You guessed it, Purdue. Boilermakers won it in 1974. And Old Dominion is returning from Clemson right about now. We'll have a complete film report of the Monarchs' triumphant return tonight at 11 o'clock. A lot of tournament upsets have changed some of the AP top 20 this week, but there is no change at the top. Indiana State, 30-0, is number one, followed by UCLA, Michigan State, Notre Dame, and Arkansas. Rounding out this year's final top 10 rankings, DePaul, LSU, Syracuse, Carolina, and Marquette. Duke was number 11. Moffitt State will play Marymount tomorrow night in the second round of the NAIA tournament. Marymount upset second-seeded Grand Canyon yesterday, and the Spartans advanced with a win over St. John Fisher. Sports director Brad Face reports from Kansas City.
We're here in the famous stockyards of Kansas City right now between shipments. But in the background is the Kemper Arena, hosting the 42nd annual NAIA basketball tournament this year. The experts tell us that of all the 32 teams playing in the first round, Norfolk State drew the very best pairing.
Norfolk State's opponent in the tournament opening game was St. John Fisher of